Welcome to Programming Knowledge. So in this video, we are going to discuss about asynchronous operations in Dart. Okay, so the question that arises is, why asynchronous operations? So the answer to that would be, asynchronous operations let your program keep running while waiting for another operation to finish. Okay, so let's say, for example, we want to store data in our server. So this type of operation doesn't execute instantly, but might take some time depending upon the internet speed or size of data, etc. So if we don't use asynchronous operation, user will have to wait until our program is interacting with the server, which will create a bad user experience. So to prevent that, we use asynchronous operations. And for this purpose, Dart provides us three special keywords to use. They are future, async, and await. So first we are going to discuss about future. Okay, so a future represents the result of an asynchronous operation and can have two states only, either uncompleted state or completed state. So how this works is, when we call an asynchronous function, it returns a uncompleted future, and then future is waiting for the function's asynchronous operation to finish or throw an error, and soon as it finishes or throws error, the future state changes from uncompleted to completed. Okay, so let's take an example. And the keyword future, we have capital F in it. Okay, so let's say we have a future method, a future function, we call it fetch user data. And what it basically does is return future dot delayed. Okay, so this means that using this delayed method, we can delay the process for some times. That is equivalent to sleep in multi-threading in Java or in any other common programming language. I mean object-oriented programming language. Okay, so then we have another class called duration, and it takes all the time parameters, that is seconds, minutes, hours, days. Okay, so for now, suppose we assume that our program will take 2 seconds to interact with the server. So I'll give it a seconds, and that is 2. That means this will wait for 2 seconds and then start executing. Okay, and we are doing this because we have assumed 2 seconds to be the time of our program to be interacting with the server. Okay, so after this we have an unnamed function which contains the code that will be executed after this delay of duration 2 seconds, and simply I want to print data. Okay, so this is our function. Now we can also specify the return type of the future. Okay, now over here in this fetch user data, I have a return keyword, but it is not actually returning any data, it is simply printing the word data. That means I am not returning anything, and if I am not returning anything, then we all know the keyword, which is void, which means this function will not return any data. Now I'll comment this out for now. Okay, now after that I'll call this method fetch user data, and after that I can say have a print statement fetching user data. Okay, so now let's try running this. Okay, so now you can see we have fetching user data first and then data. But actually, according to the convention, we have first called fetch user data, which is this method, so this should be printed first. So that means our delay function is working fine, and that is how the asynchronous functions work. That means over here, if there is a delay of 2 seconds, it will not wait for 2 seconds to execute the rest of the code, it will directly start executing the rest of the code, and as soon as this finishes, the future states become completed and it hardly affects the rest of the execution of the program. So then this function is called an asynchronous function. Okay, that means our program is still running and not caring about the completion of this function, means the completion of execution of this function. Okay, so this is how we use futures. Okay, so the next thing that we are going to discuss is async and await. So these keywords provide a declarative way to define a async function and use their result. Okay, so let's say this function remains same and instead of printing data, now it actually returns something and which is eventually a string. Okay, so means after 2 seconds data will be returned. Okay, and now if it is returning string, I need to change this to string. Okay, and now after that, over here I'll create another method which is string, and I'll call it user message. Okay, anything that we like. And then what it basically does is var data is equal to fetch user data, means we are calling this method. Okay, and then I am simply printing this, simply returning a string, because we have a string return type here, return data. And now in our main method, all we do is we remove all these thing and we write print user msg. Okay, now over here you can see it is giving us an error, so all we can do is surround it inside quotes and do string interpolation. Okay, so now Dart will infer that it is a string. So now let's try running this and see what is the output. Okay, so as according to the convention, the output should be data, but instead of that we are getting a future of string. That means, as I earlier said, if we execute a future, it returns a future, and that is in uncompleted state and it is expecting to be completed or thrown error. Okay, so now over here you can see what basically happened was that this function was executed, and as this is a asynchronous operation, it didn't wait for this function to finish and returned the data. And why? And since this was not yet finished, it returned the incomplete state of future, and that is why we are getting such type of output. Okay, so this is what we call a uncompleted future. Okay, and a completed future has a proper accurate value. Okay, so I hope you are understanding what I am trying to say. And now to prevent such type of error, what we need to do is we will use the async and await keyword. Okay, so what await keyword basically does is that it will wait for this function to execute, or basically it will wait for this function's future to be of completed state. Okay, and then this await function is giving an error over here, and that is because await function never goes without async function. Okay, async and await always go together. Okay, if we write await and don't write async, it will give us an error. However, vice versa will not give an error, and that is because async is just allowing that function to use await, and then if we don't use await, then that is not a problem. But if we use await and we have not allowed that function to use await, then that thing will give us a problem. Okay, I hope you are understanding these things. Now, as you can see, this is now a asynchronous function. And over here also you have seen a asynchronous function, but the difference between these two asynchronous functions were this asynchronous function returns a future, while this asynchronous function is returning a string. and that is why we are getting a error over here, because asynchronous functions always return a future. Okay, so instead of string, this will now be future string. So now it is a future string, and since it also will now return over here a uncompleted state of future, and we want a completed state of future, that means we want some actual result, we will use await over here also. And now since this is using await, we need to give async over here. Keep in mind, async is always after the ending parentheses and before the opening curly braces. Okay, so now let's try running this program, and now instead of getting this instance, we should be able to see this data being printed. So let's see, and you can see as soon as the execution is completed, it waits for 2 seconds and then data is being printed. So it is waiting for 2 seconds because over here we have used await, which is making the program stop for 2 seconds until this has a completed state of future, and the same goes over here. So this were all the basics about future, async and await. Okay, so I hope everything was clear. Thank you.